Yo, boys, what's happening? It's Wizzy here. This is part of a video series of the 10 Laws of Long Distance Shooting. So this is going to be a really important video series that's going to cover the things that you need to know about Warzone sniping and ground war sniping. Law number one, make sure you're sniping at a distance. Now I know that can sound really, really obvious to people who are more experienced, and obviously you clicked on this because you want to know a little bit more about sniping at a distance. But it really is an important reminder that's honestly worth mentioning. A lot of people will try and play very aggressive and try to play up in other people's face, but really, if you're going to be long distance, you're probably not going to be running something that has a lot of ADS speed. That's why it's important to fight at a distance and always have a backup gun, especially if you're in Warzone. Something like an SMG, LMG, or an assault rifle will come in handy. Just a quick interrupter, guys, before we move on to Law 2, it's important to know that this is not a setup video, this is just a tips and tricks type of tutorial. So the next video is going to be showing my setup, but please continue watching because these next things are really important. Alright, so Law 2 is going to be pick higher ground, if you can. Sometimes in Warzone we're not always given the choice what we get to choose and where we get to go, because everybody is all around the map and the final circle is this way and you gotta go and you only have 30 seconds. Don't freak out about that stuff, but you will definitely be at a better place and your team will probably have better positioning if you are. And the third law, guys, is to think about the distance. In Warzone and in Ground War and in those long range maps, there actually is bullet dropping Call of Duty. So you'll have to aim a little bit above them if they're really far away, or if they're running, you might have to aim a little bit ahead of them because, like as I said before, there is bullet drop. And something that's definitely worth the mentioning is to always aim for a headshot in Warzone if you can. That'll immediately down anyone, but if you hit them on the body, it'll start taking away their vest and it'll eventually crack them, but it will not down them in one shot. So you're definitely gonna have to aim for the head for those long distance shots. That's why the last comment of aiming over the head is super important. Number four is use your environment. Yo, you gotta slide to a boulder, you gotta peek behind that tree, you gotta use that building to your advantage. If you can peek up and get a dome, that is probably one of the best ways to get a snipe off. And that's probably the safest way to get a snipe off, is using your environment to your advantage, making sure that you know whether you have the high ground or the low ground, and using that information to get your sniping kills. And law number five, guys, you have to know your ranges. It's gonna take a lot of practice, especially in Warzone or wherever. You have to know how far ahead you have to plan or lead your bullet, and then you have to know how far above their head you're gonna have to aim in order to get that headshot. Thank you guys so much for sticking around to watch the first part of the video series, 10 Laws to Long Distance Sniping. It is gonna be an awesome video series, and I plan on going over my setup in the next video. It'd definitely be a lot longer, but this is just a quick thing that I wanted to get out there to you guys because I know you guys have been asking for it. And I'm super excited for this next part of the video series. Much love, as always. Wizzy out.